Hello children. Children, last week we have done lesson number 2, A Light for the Palace Fire, and the poem AEIOU of English 2. I hope children you all have done your work in your books as well as copies. So today we are going to start with a new lesson of English 1. Take out your English grammar books. Take out page number 19. On page number 19, we are going to start with lesson number 5, that is the noun. Children, noun I taught you in class 2 also. I hope you remember what is a noun. So before we do the book exercises, let's study about what is a noun. Now children, I will write here a few examples like Sunil is a good student. The dogs are barking. He writes with a pen. Then he lives in Delhi. Now children, here I have written 4 sentences. Sunil is a good student, the dogs are barking, he writes with the pen, and he lives in Delhi. Now in these 4 sentences, children, can you tell me which is the name of a person in the first sentence? That is Sunil. Sunil is the name of a person. Now in the next sentence, the dogs are barking. Can you tell me any name here? That is dogs. Dogs is the name of an animal. Sunil is the name of a person. Dogs is the name of an animal. Next sentence, he writes with a pen. Can you tell me the name of anything here? Pen. Here pen is the name of a thing. In the last sentence, he lives in Delhi. Delhi is the name of a place. Delhi is the name of a place. So what we can say here? Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or a thing. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or a thing. Now here in all these 4 sentences, Sunil is the name of a person, dogs is the name of an animal, pen is the name of a thing, and Delhi is the name of a place. So all these 4 words are nouns. What are they called? Nouns. Because they refer to a name of a person, place, animal, or a thing. Let me give you some more examples regarding this. Kavita is reading the book. Here in this example, which is a noun, children? Kavita, because it is the name of a person. Book, because it is the name of a thing. He is going to the market. What is market here? It is the name of a place. So this is also a noun. Yes or no? Market is also a noun because it is the name of a place. Mumbai is a big city. Here, Mumbai is the name of a city. So this is also a noun. Yes, because it is the name of a place. So Mumbai is also a noun. The books are on the table. Here books and table, these are the names of the things. So these are also nouns. So I hope children you understood what is a noun. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal or a thing. Once again I am repeating. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal or a thing. Now children, let's move on to different kinds of noun. Now we are going to study about the different kinds of noun. Children, can you tell me how many different kinds of noun are there? There are 5 different kinds of noun. There are 5 different kinds of noun. Let's start with the first one. The first one is proper noun. The second one is common noun. Next is collective noun. Next is abstract noun. And then the last one is material noun. I will repeat the kinds of noun once again. Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, abstract noun and material noun. Now children, I will explain you all these different kinds of noun one by one. First of all, let's start with proper noun. Children, proper nouns are the particular names given to a person, place, animal or a thing. What is a proper noun? Proper noun is a particular name, or you can say specific name, which is given to a person, place, animal or a thing. Like for example, Ram is a good boy. Here the name of the boy is Ram. Means some particular name is given to that boy, that is Ram. So Ram is the name of a person. It is that particular name which is given to that boy. So it is called a proper noun. Next example I will give you. He lives in Kolkata. Kolkata is the name of a city, a particular place. So here the name is given to a particular place. So Kolkata is also a proper noun. Next, I am going to Delhi on Monday. Here, children, Delhi is the name of a particular place. So it is also a proper noun. Monday, it is the name of the day of the week. It is a particular name which is given to a particular day of the week. So this is also a proper noun. I will give you one more example. His dog's name is Robin. Now, Robin is the particular name which is given to that dog. So, this is also a proper noun. So, children, in all these above sentences, you can see that some particular name is given to a person, place, animal or a thing. Understood? So these are called proper nouns, like Ram, Kolkata, Delhi, Monday, Robin. These are the particular names which are given to a person, place, animal or a thing. So they are called proper nouns. Now one more thing related to proper nouns I want to tell you, that proper nouns always begin with a capital letter. Proper nouns always begin with a capital letter. Whether these proper nouns come at the beginning of the sentence or at the mid of the sentence or at the end of the sentence, wherever they come, listen to me very carefully. Proper nouns, wherever they come, whether at the beginning of the sentence or at the mid of the sentence or at the end of the sentence, wherever we are using proper nouns, their first letter will be capital only. because proper nouns always begin with a capital letter. So here you can see in the above example, children, Ram. Here Ram is coming at the beginning of the sentence. So it is a name of a name is a particular name given to a person. So R is capital. Here Kolkata is the name of a particular city. It comes at the end of the sentence, but still K will be capital. Here Delhi comes in the middle of the sentence. It is the name of the place. So here D will be capital. And here again at the end of the sentence, Robin, it is the name of a dog. So R will be capital. So I hope children you have understood what is a proper noun. Now let's move on to another kind of noun, that is common noun. Now we are going to start with common noun. Children, common noun is the general name given to a person, place, animal, or a thing. Common noun is the general name given to a person, place, animal, or a thing. Like for example, boy, girl, friend, father, mother, city, dog, etc. So here children, I have given you so many examples like boy, girl, friend, father, mother, city, dog. All these are common nouns. Now what is a common noun? Children, in proper noun I told you that some specific or particular name is given to a person, place, animal, or a thing. But in common noun, a general name is given to the same group. Like a general name is given to a group which is of the same kind. I will explain you through examples. He is a clown. Here the word clown is used in general for a person. Here the name of the clown is not mentioned. Only it is written he is a clown. So the word clown is used in general for a person. The dog is sleeping. Here the word dog is used in general for the dog. Here the name of that particular dog is not written. Only the word dog is written. So it is a common noun. So this dog is used for animal. The word dog is used in general for an animal. He writes with a pen. Here pen is used for a thing. Means here the word pen is used in general for a thing. We have not written here the name of any particular pen. We have only written that he writes with a pen. So here pen is used in general for a thing. He lives in a big city. Here city is a noun because here we have not mentioned the name of that particular city. We have only mentioned that he lives in a big city. So city is also the name of a place. So the word city is used in general for the place. So all these words like clown, dog, pen, city, and some more examples I have given above like boy, girl, friend, father, mother, all these are common nouns. Like suppose children, I give you an example. In a class, the teacher is teaching. Both boys and girls are sitting in the class. The teacher asks, girls, give me the answer to this question. Means the teacher is not taking the particular name of any girl child. She is just telling all the girls to give the answer to the question. So the word girls is used for all the girls. Means it is commonly used for all the girls. And then she asks the boys, boys, stand up. So she here also, she is not taking the name of any particular boy. She is only telling all the boys. So the word boy is used for all the boys sitting in the class. So that is called a common noun. What is it called? Common noun. Children, till here I will explain you in this video. In the next video, I will explain you the rest of the kinds of noun. Thank you.